Yes. Good afternoon, my Edo people. I remain your civil rights noble activist, Comrade Aibogun Emmanuel. And you know, very lately I discovered that there's a huge, you know, fraud, you know, coronating with the 1 year anniversary of our governor Nogegasa Obaseki, that is looming. And that is in play by the so-called political gladiators, you know, that is in charge of governance in the state. And that is why I came, because I want to begin to let those of you who listen to the message, some of us come up online to advocate and to send across to you via the platform of social media. As at this very hour now, I just want to start first of all by also thanking the good people of Edo State, who have remained resilient in ensuring that good governance remains the watchword in which, you know, our government is being formulated, and you know, policies of government is also being carried out. At the very just now, I know most of you will know this book before me. Most of you who are watching me now will know this book. In this book, you have chapters of it that formulates our Nigerian constitution. That is the panacea for you and I to exist as not just Edo people, not just Benin people, not just Afemai people, not just Esan, Esako and the rest. It's for us to exist as a Nigerian sovereign state. And in the constitution of this book, I want to take a very close verse, a very close chapter, before I tell you the way forward in which Edo people must, you know, begin to advocate on. I will be very brief to take you to chapter 1, section 11, chapter 1 of the Nigerian Constitution. That states, and I'm going to read it out for you. Yeah, it states, sorry, chapter 2, chapter 2, paragraph 2 of the Nigerian Constitution. It states, and I'm going to read it out to you. It says, sovereignty belongs to the people. Sovereignty belongs to the people of Nigeria, from whom government through this constitution derives all its powers and authority. The security and welfare of the people shall be the primary purpose of government, and the participation by the people in their government shall be ensured in accordance with the provision of this constitution. If I want to continue going all and all and all and all and all and all and all again, it will take more of my time, because I want to spend just 10 minutes while I send the direct message. The powers that the people have is in this PVC, is in this voter's card. The power that these politicians have is also in this voter's card. When you vote criminals, hoodlums, cultists into the seat of government, the kind of Nigerian state we have, despite we having democracy that we yearn for, is what we'll be getting all along. Because the ideals of these criminals is to enrich themselves and their estate. Inasmuch as our people continue towing the path in which they sell their votes to these criminals who come around with money, the latter effect of what some of us are lamenting over now will continue. And what do we need to do with this PVC? Those of you who find yourself within the shores of the diaspora, I want you to know that it is those of you who can give us the healing that we need in Nigeria. How do you do it? You are going to pick up your cell phones and begin to tell people from now, stop selling your votes. Because it is now a norm in our society that those persons in the seat of government, they indulge in selling their, in buying the votes of we the electorates. Because you will see them when the time is there for election, they will come, give you, they will come to a unit, they will say they have a village head, they have the other head, they have that one, they give you all sort of offices when it's time for election, and they convince you with the little token they give to us. If we must allow Nigeria to change, we must begin to call back our people home to make good use of this PVC. But while this information is going on, I want to let you people know that come January 2018, because of the challenges some of us have to move advocacy forward to the next level, or to move our own civil society organization and organizing the public to the next level, we are going to start advocacy come January, 2nd of January 2018. And in that advocacy, we are going to go across the 192 words, telling them this message I just told you, preaching what their power is in the Constitution. Without this, we go nowhere. And lastly, to those of us who are youths, who are privileged to find ourselves within the orbits of social media, if you take a closer look to the society where we find ourselves, when you're telling Edo State, that state, and I'm going to read it out for you. Yeah, it states, sorry, chapter 2, chapter 2, paragraph 2 of the Nigerian Constitution. It states, and I'm going to read it out to you. It says, sovereignty belongs to the people. Sovereignty belongs to the people of Nigeria, from whom government, through this constitution, derives all its powers and authority. The security and welfare of the people shall be the primary purpose of government, and the participation by the people in their government shall be ensured in accordance with the provision of this constitution. If I want to continue going all and all and all and all and all and all and all again, it will take more of my time, because I want to spend just 10 minutes while I send the direct message. The powers that the people have is in this PVC, is in this voter's card. The power that these politicians have is also in this voter's card. When you vote criminals, hoodlums, cultists into the seat of government, the kind of Nigerian state we have, despite we having democracy that we yearn for, is what we'll be getting all along. Because the ideals of these criminals is to enrich themselves and their estate. Inasmuch as our people continue towing the path in which they sell their votes to these criminals who come around with money, the latter effect of what some of us are lamenting over now will continue. And what do we need to do with this PVC? Those of you who find yourself within the shores of the diaspora, I want you to know that it is those of you who can give us the healing that we need in Nigeria. How do you do it? You are going to pick up your cell phones and begin to tell people from now, stop selling your votes. Because it is now a norm in our society that those persons in the seat of government, they indulge in selling their, in buying the votes of we the electorates. Because you will see them when their time is there for a lot of government. And the participation by the people in their government shall be ensured in accordance with the provision of this constitution. If I want to continue going all and all and all and all and all and all and all again, it will take more of my time, because I want to spend just 10 minutes while I send the direct message. The powers that the people have is in this PVC. Is in this voter's card. The power that these politicians have is also in this voter's card. When you vote criminals, hoodlums, cultists into the seat of government, the kind of Nigerian state we have, despite we having democracy that we yearn for, is what we'll be getting all along. Because the ideals of these criminals is to enrich themselves and their estate. Inasmuch as our people continue towing the path in which they sell their votes to these criminals who come around with money, the latter effect of what some of us are lamenting over now will continue. And what do we need to do with this PVC? Those of you who find yourself within the shores of the diaspora, I want you to know that it is those of you who can give us the healing that we need in Nigeria. How do you do it? You are going to pick up your cell phones and begin to tell people from now, stop selling your votes. Because it is now a norm in our society that those persons in the seat of government, they indulge in selling their, in buying the votes of we the electorates. Because you will see them when their time is there for election, they will come, give you, they will come to a unit, they will say they have a village head, they have the other head, they have that one, they give you all sort of offices when it's time for election. And they convince you with the little token they give to us. If we must allow Nigeria to change, we must begin to call back our people home to make good use of this PVC. But while this information is going on, I want to let you people know that come January 2018, because of the challenge